Samarth, so as we continue to stay with these visuals, whether it's Lucknow, whether it's Amethi, both these constituencies will be very crucial. Because while there is a Samajwadi Party candidate who has been fielded from Lucknow against Rajnath Singh, while we are waiting for that moment for Amethi, and will it be Rahul Gandhi? What do you think that at this point the BJP strategy will be, specifically in Amethi? Because they may have a candidate, Ravidas Mehrotra from Samajwadi Party in Lucknow. They're still waiting for Amethi. But do you think BJP wants to not take chances and continue to ensure their presence is seen on the ground?
Well, exactly. That has been the strategy for the BJP. If you see the nomination thing, then BJP seems to be ahead with the opposition parties. We saw that in Kannauj, where Subrat Pathak did that before Akhilesh Yadav. We saw that in Lucknow. We are seeing that in Lucknow with Rajnath Singh filing nomination papers today before Ravidas Malhotra, the Samajwadi Party candidate. The same scenario is happening in Amethi, where Smriti Irani is going to file the nomination papers today, days before the finalization of the candidate of the Congress party, and also for that particular candidate to file the nomination papers. So BJP seems to be ahead, at least in this nomination game. Whatever be the result from Amethi, Lucknow, or Rae Bareli, or Kannauj, it's going to be very worth seeing that BJP has yet again shown its discipline, be it in the form of selection of candidates, be it in the form of punctuality in terms of nomination papers. Though for Rae Bareli, BJP has also not announced a candidate. For Kasargod, BJP has not announced this candidate, because it is also being seen as a strategy, as Akhilesh Yadav did in Kannauj, by in a way announcing his name on the final day of the nomination. So that has been the strategies for the party, but it's going to be worth seeing how this nomination thing, how this strategy thing works for both Congress and BJP. Because if you talk about Lucknow, it's complete. It has turned into the bastion of the Sapan party, with such visuals all over BJP workers, all around the roads of Hazratganj or the collectorate. You will just see the Sapan flags all around. And same is other visuals coming from Amethi. So this is the thing to worry for the Samajwadi Party and the Congress Party. Where is Ravidas Malhotra, Samajwadi Party? Or will we see such show of strength on May 1 when Ravidas Malhotra will be filing nomination from Lucknow, or when Rahul Gandhi will be filing nomination from Amethi? We have to wait for their show of strength, whether it will be bigger than BJP, or BJP in a way will take a lead in terms of show of strength. Back to you.
When is the nomination going to be filed? Because I can see that from the past 1 hour at least, Samarth, you've been on the road. There have been visits to the temple, then the roadshow. Amethi's roadshow is presently on. What is their strategy with this show of strength on the ground?
Well, exactly. If you talk about this particular election, I haven't seen any such show of strength before. In Kannauj, I've covered other districts as well, where be it the BJP candidate or the Samajwadi Party candidate, not any show of strength happened just like that. But this is something unusual happening in Lucknow, because it's not just about one particular caste or one particular
Samar,
region.
Samar, stay on with me. From Lucknow, Abhishek Mishra joins me now from Amethi. Go ahead, Abhishek, what do you see around you?
सीधे तौर पर इस सीट पर स्मृति ईरानी का ही दावा है. दूसरी बार यहाँ पर बड़ी जीत के लिए आ रही है. 50,000 का मार्जिन पिछली बार था, लेकिन इस बार 5 लाख का दावा हो रहा है. और यही कारण है बड़ी समर्थकों के प्रचार में स्मृति ईरानी की मौजूदगी यहाँ पर दिखाई दे रही है. राहुल गांधी आएगी कि नहीं, कांग्रेस से कौन आएगा, क्या गांधी प्रचार अभी तैयार है कि नहीं, इस पर फिलहाल पशुओं पर पड़ा हुआ है. और इसका पूरा फायदा जो है कांग्रेस के बजाय बीजेपी को मिलता नजर आता है, जहां कार्यकर्ता बड़ी संख्या में पक्ष में नजर आ रहे हैं.
So that's Abhishek Mishra in Amethi, Samarth Srivastav in Lucknow. Look at the visuals on your screen. Accompanying Rajnath Singh, the incumbent defense minister, the MP from Lucknow, accompanied by Pushkar Singh Dhami, Uttarakhand chief minister, Yogi Adityanath holding the lotus symbol in his hand, Uttar Pradesh chief minister. Both of them, these are big guns, remember, for the BJP, and in a state which has become a Bharatiya Janata Party bastion. While Rajnath Singh is no stranger to Lucknow, his family hails from Lucknow and they clearly know the constituency well. But it will be as much about not just winning, but the margin that they will gain. Ravidas Mehrotra, the Samajwadi Party candidate, the India Bloc candidate against him. While you're looking at the roadshow in Amethi, The numbers speaking for themselves, the BJP ensuring that Kadar is out in full force. Both Lucknow and Amethi will be very important. Lucknow because it is the capital city of the state and has, of course, a huge history attached to it. But Amethi is the Gandhi bastion and the BJP will not want to make it look like it is just a fluke that Smriti Irani won previously. They'll want to show it's the impact on the ground. And that is why, whether it's Rahul Gandhi, whether it's any other candidate, which the India Bloc Alliance is still mulling about, Smriti Irani is on the ground, not taking any chances, not taking it for granted, wants to ensure that she's seen with the people and with the campaign as well. Because if she wins this time, whether it's about her work or to beat anti-incumbency or the Modi factor, it will be a proof further enough that BJP has made a stronghold and it wasn't just a one-off victory in 2019 by Smriti Irani. We are putting it out on your screen how Amethi, once a Gandhi bastion, repeatedly won by Sonia Gandhi, whether it was in Rai Bareli or for the Gandhi family like Rahul Gandhi in Amethi, can that now be breached by the BJP? Samarth Srivastav continues to be with me on this. Samarth, what sort of arrangements do you see on the ground? Because when are we then expecting this roadshow to get over? What do you hear? What is Yogi Adityanath saying from atop that vehicle? What is Dhami saying? Tell us more. Abhishek Mishra is now joining me also from Amethi. Abhishek, if you can hear me, and I understand there must be a lot of sound around you. How many people, what sort of a show of strength that we can say BJP has pulled off in Amethi for Smriti Irani? Abhishek, if you can hear me, what do you see around you? Go ahead. Okay, clearly, we can understand a lot of music and sloganeering on the ground. It's not the easiest of times for our reporters on the ground also to be able to communicate in here. And they'll be sending us ground reports consistently and we'll play that out for you. But look at how the streets have turned saffron in parts of Lucknow and Amethi. Rajnath Singh will want to ensure that the city known for history and culture, but also now development, a manufacturing unit for the BrahMos missile, all of that will now become a factor for the BJP to be voted again, and it will be Rajnath Singh to represent as a defense minister who has continued to maintain how India's border are now totally secure. But apart from that, for Amethi, for Smriti Irani, she'll want to prove, while she continues to challenge Rahul Gandhi, that irrespective, and she had said this earlier, whether it's the brother or the brother-in-law, people are voting for Narendra Modi and they will win. And very interesting, look at how there are BJP also attempting to show that accompanying them for the nomination for their leaders are chief ministers. So they've pulled out Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Mohan Yadav to accompany Smriti Irani. For Rajnath Singh, he will be accompanied, and currently you can see Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath and Uttarakhand Chief Minister Pushkar Singh Dhami. This is also about how the BJP has managed to have solid governments in these states, specifically in the northern belt of the country. So this is a big story. In just a short while, both Smriti Irani and Rajnath Singh will be filing their nomination, and then, of course, more election campaigning to follow. The third phase arriving in just the next few days, and of course, it will be the big day for the BJP.